Are you sick of needing a lot of currency to magic find efficiently? Are you sick of the same old tornado shot character you always use? This build is none of that. Let me introduce you to the Poverty Strike Raider. This build uses no headhunter, no inspired learnings, and no crazy expensive helm enchants. This build works both solo and in group play, has over 1.5 million Shaper DPS in magic find gear, and can with just a gear swap take care of most of the content the game throws at you. In this guide, however, we will focus on magic finding both solo and in group play. In the background of this guide, you will see clips of solo play and play with a Aura bot. Remember to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and you can find me on Twitch Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday at 10 PM. Let's start this guide off with talking about our skill gems. We are using Lightning Strike as our main skill. The reason for this is we can find a 21-23 Vol Lightning Strike for under 10 Chaos Orbs. Lightning Strike has been buffed for a couple of leagues, has inherent good clear, and a buffed shock so that you shock for a minimum of 5%. This makes Lightning Strike a great clear skill and an okay single target skill. So our main link will be Lightning Strike, physical to lightning support, elemental damage with attack support, melee physical support, fortify support, or hypothermia support. You can go hypothermia support for more damage, or you can go fortify support for the quality of life of always having fortify. Ancestral Call for a single target, and then we swap Ancestral Call for Ruthless when we're fighting bosses or metamorphs. This main link will stay the same if you're playing solo or if you're playing in a group. Additional links are Herald of Ice with Curse on Hit, Assassin's Mark. This will give you power charges when you're clearing. Cast 1 damage taken, Immortal Call, and Summon Ice Golem. This setup I keep at level 1 Cast 1 damage taken, level 3 Immortal Call, and level 3 Ice Golem. Doing it this way, we try to trigger Cast 1 damage taken as often as possible to summon our Ice Golem and trigger Immortal Call. The reason we do it this way is to try to keep our Ice Golem up at all times, and also since we're using Whirling Blades, we might end up in a pack sometimes and then triggering Immortal Call straight away and having 26% reduced physical damage taken and 25% reduced elemental damage taken for 1 second. It's a great thing to trigger instantly so we don't get one shot. For our auras, we use Hatred and Precision linked with Enlightened support. You can balance this out by using a low level precision and drop the Enlighten, or you can level up your precision and have like level 3 or level 4 Enlighten for some more mana. Other than that, we're using Whirling Blades linked with faster attacks and Calling Strike. We're using Ancestral Protector for more attack speed when we place it, and we're using a Blood Rage. So if you're playing with an Aura bot, they usually have all the auras like Hatred, Precision, Wrath and stuff like that. But you can't get your Heralds from an Aura bot, so we're using Herald of Ice, Herald of Purity, and Flesh and Stone in Sand Stance if we're playing with an Aura bot. Sand Stance on Flesh and Stone will blind nearby enemies, which give you increased survivability, and you take 11% less damage from attacks from enemies that aren't nearby you while in Sand Stance. Okay, let's go over to gear. We start with our weapons. We are looking for high PDPS weapons with the Temple mod of added lightning damage and damage penetrates lightning resistance. We want this mod on both our weapons. However, these weapons can be rare since you can't craft the Temple mod, but I managed to find my weapons for 80 chaos for one of them and 90 chaos for the other one. I've put a link for the search filter in the video description. For the other items, we are using Sadimas Touch with +1 Frenzy Charge, Biscos Leash, Goldwyrm Boots, a Quant Amulet, 2 Ventors Gambles, a rare helmet with Lightning Strike pierces 3 additional targets, and we try to craft this with nearby enemies have -9% lightning resistance, and also a rare chest piece, which we try to get attacks have +2 critical strike chance, some resistance, and maybe some life. The order I would buy your equipment is your gloves, your boots, and your 2 Biscos first, and then you buy all the rest of the gear and try to balance your resistance between those 4 parts. If you don't have enough resistance, you can drop Biscos Leash for a rare belt with some resistance and maybe some life and elemental damage to attack skills or lightning damage or elemental damage. If you're playing with an Aura bot, you're dropping both your Ventor's Gambles for Pariah Rings with 1 white socket. This will give you more quantity, and an Aura bot almost always runs all of the purity, so you'll have your resistances anyway. If you can't afford the weapons or can't find any weapons with these mods, you could also run Rebuke of the Vol, which sells for around 30 to 40 chaos, so that's a really cheap choice. And if you can't afford the rare Quant Amulet, which can be expensive, you can also go for a Biscos Collar. You can also look for a Biscos Collar corrupted with plus to all elemental resistances. There's one selling right now for 25 chaos, so that's a really good cheap choice. And you don't really need the plus 2 critical strike chance on your chest either, so you can just go for a 6 link with some resistance and some life. For our flasks, we're picking up Aetsiri's Promise, which give you Physis extra chaos, Elementalis extra chaos, and chaos damage leeches life. This is one of our sources for leech. We're using a diamond flask with immunity to bleeding. We're using a silver flask with curse immunity. We're using Lion's Roar, which give you more physical damage, and we're scaling a lot of our damage from physical. And we're using a Taste of Hate, which give you fish as extra cold. Okay, so for our skill tree, we start off going life into Heart of the Oak for some more life. Then we're going down to Primeval Force for elemental damage and penetration. We're going over here, grabbing more life and grabbing these crit strike chance and accuracy nodes. Then we're going up, grabbing sword nodes with some block chance, damage, attack speed, crit strike chance, and crit multi. Frenzy Charge, Jewel Socket, more crit strike chance and crit multi, acrobatics, face acrobatics. Go in here, grab this, elemental damage and more penetration. We're stacking a lot of penetration. More life, another Frenzy Charge, another Jewel Socket, up here more life and some crit strike chance, crit multi. After you picked up that, you're going this way and you're picking up another Frenzy Charge here, more life. You're picking up these nodes, which give you evasion per frenzy charge, movement speed per frenzy charge, attack speed per frenzy charge, and some damage per frenzy charge, and also plus one to minimum frenzy charge, so we'll always be at one minimum, one frenzy charge. Grabbing the jewel socket over here, grabbing these are crit strike chance and crit multi with swords and also fist damage. Grabbing this, it's melee critical strike chance and multiplier. Then we're grabbing this jewel socket. I need some extra intelligence on my build, so I grab that. After this is at 91. After that, you're going to pick up Bloodless, and you're also going to pick up Solo Steel. So you do this by going there. You're picking up Solo Steel for additional physical damage reduction and maximum resistance, and then we're picking up the life. For our jewel sockets, we are trying to get attack speed while dual wielding, crit strike chance, and crit multi. That's what we're stacking. So every jewel I have is attack speed and crit multi, preferably. We're trying to stack as much crit multi as possible because we are close to like 80% crit strike chance with our flasks up. So as you can see, more attack speed, crit strike chance, and attack speed. And here we got attack speed, crit multi, melee crit multi, and crit multi with lightning skills. So this is optimal. This is what you're looking for. I'd like to have four of these to put in all my jewel sockets, but it's kind of hard to find. In the description, you will find the filter I use to search for my jewels, and you can pick out your gems for which you want for your character. So for our ascendancy, the first one we're picking up is Way of the Poacher. This will make you have permanent frenzy charges even on bosses. Then we're going Avatar of the Slaughter, which gives you a lot of bonuses per frenzy charge. So you get evasion, movement speed, attack speed, and attack damage per frenzy charge. That's why we're picking up a lot of frenzy charges in the tree, and also the reason we're looking for a Sadimas Touch with plus one frenzy charge. After that, we're picking up Quartz Infusion, which gives you a bit more dodge, elemental damage, and it also gives you facing. Facing makes you able to run through enemies without them blocking you, so you don't get like stuck in between enemies. And after that, we're picking up Avatar of the Veil, which gives you increased movement speed while facing. It also gives you immunity to elemental ailments while facing. This is the reason we don't have like freeze immunity or burning immunity on our flasks, because we're immune to those while we have facing, and we always have facing. It also gives you spell dodge, an additional 10% spell dodge, and it gives nearby enemies elemental exposure, which reduces their resistances by 15. So our cold the enemy's cold resistance and lightning resistance are reduced by 15, and they also have reduced accuracy. So this, together with say blood and flesh and stone, when we're in a party, makes the enemies miss you a lot. So we're kind of survivable even though we only have 4k life. That concludes the guide for this character. I hope you enjoyed it, and I want to thank everyone who made it this far in the video. You will find the path of building and useful links in the description, and I'll see you in the next one.